first ever global aviation summit is taking place in Mumbai over the next 2 days. This will be the first of its kind event in India, with participation expected from more than 86 countries. CNBC TV18's Utkarsh Chatterjee caught up with Jayant Sinha on the sidelines of that conference and began by asking him how long before India becomes an international aviation hub.
We are already progressing very well towards making some of our major airports as hubs. So Delhi, of course, has added many, many international destinations. Mumbai has had many destinations, but has not been able to add too many because of obviously capacity constraints. But it is Bangalore that is coming up very quickly that I think is going to become another major global hub for India. Bangalore is adding a second runway and a second terminal. And what is very important is that we have to design our terminals to enable transfers. So whether it is a domestic-to-domestic transfer, domestic-to-international, international-to-international, all of these transfers have to be facilitated in our terminals, and that's what enables a global hub to be established. At the same time, our airlines also have to be able to put a number of flights to many of these destinations. And increasingly, as our Indian carriers add international destinations, they will also be able to enable a global hub to happen. All of these have been underway over the last few years, but particularly with the design of the new terminals in Bangalore and Delhi, and then the growth of Navi Mumbai, we will certainly be able to establish some of our airports as major global hubs.
Will there be policy assistance from the government on the same as well? And what can we
the do? Assistance that we are providing is to be able to support our industry in every way possible to make investments attractive. And so we are working on all of these policies. Many of them have already been enabled through the National Civil Aviation Policy.
Jayant, you spoke about the industry growth, but do you think that the fuel price, when it went up, was a bit jarring in the growth? And how do you see that right now? Because jet fuel, as we see, is bleeding, and it has had an impact on the growth which we were expecting for the industry.
Fuel prices have been volatile for decades now, and everybody that operates in the airline industry understands that they have to take appropriate hedging and risk mitigation measures when it comes to fuel prices. So the best airlines, the best carriers are appropriately hedged. They know exactly how to manage that volatility.
Are you comfortable with the current pricing right now? As a minister, are you not concerned with what the kind of volatility?
We would like oil prices to be as low and stable. Of course, that's what we would like, but these prices are set through global markets, so we have to be able to handle any ups and downs.
Last question from my side, sir. Speaking about Air India privatization, we have been speaking about the subsidiaries now are being going for privatization as soon as possible. The EOI is supposed to come. What is the update there?
We are proceeding forward. The group of ministers has made certain decisions with respect to the disinvestment of subsidiaries. That process is underway, and let us wait for the results to come in.
Okay, all right. We have TV18 broadcast numbers that are up for you on the screen. Revenue is up by close to around 22%. The subscription number as well was higher. The EBITDA number, in fact, is up by close to around 40%. And subscription number, I think, was up by close to around 13% or thereabouts. Yeah, that's up for you on the screen. Standard disclosure, owner of the channel that you're currently watching. The stock up close to around 3% as we speak. But the markets, though, we have come off a tad bit from the top, 25 points from the top. A couple of stocks that are seeing selling. Axis Bank had a good run with ICICI Bank. Now, that's come off the high point of the day. So keep an eye out on that one. Technically, though, we are still holding above the 200 DMA. So whether or not you should be buying into this dip, Ashwini Gujral as well as Rajat Bose join us. Good day, gentlemen. Thanks so much for joining in. Ashwini, coming across to you. What would your call be now on the Nifty? Is there a fresh trade? And if you had that long position from yesterday, then where do you place your stop loss at? Earlier today, you had told us at around that 10,600 odd mark that was yesterday's low.
See, now you can update it to 10,780. And on the Bank Nifty, basically 27,400. So as long as these levels are maintained, you should hold on to your long position. Overall, several large caps are doing well. So chances are that we should be able to hold on to 10,770. Having said that, Tech Mahindra is a buy with a stop of 690, target of 725. You have Colte Patil, which is a buy with a stop of 260, target of 276. And HPCL is a buy with a stop of 234, target of 248.
Ashwini, Tech Mahindra is a buy. What about Infosys smart moves over the last 2 days?
See, I think it's moved up quite a bit. And now, you know, on declines, Infosys remains a buy. I think the IT space with today's move seems to have made some sort of a bottom, and that could outperform from here.
Okay. Okay, let's get Rajat as well into the conversation. Rajat, what's your trade on the Nifty? We have still hit a century today, up close to around 100 points.
So long as 10,840 is maintained, there is a possibility that we can see higher levels, and especially 10,867, if crossed, then 10,880 to about 890 would be the next target. Of course, 10,900 needs to be crossed decisively before a sustainable up move happens. But today's move is definitely very encouraging, because after a long time, quite a few days, hence we are seeing this kind of a move on the upside. I would also go for tech stocks, particularly some mid-cap stocks like Hexaware. Hexaware and Tata Elxsi, the two stocks I have chosen, they have similar features. They are actually consolidating at the bottom, and now they are moving up. They are in a range-bound situation for the last 3 months. Tata Elxsi between 950 and 1050, and Hexaware between 310 and 340, and both the stocks are rising from their bottoms. So there is very little risk, but chances of good upside on the way. Hexaware buy with a stop below 317.90, targets 325 and 328. Tata Elxsi, it's a positional call, buy with a stop below 959, 1016 and 1043 are the two targets for Tata Elxsi positional call.
Okay, going with midcap IT, Rajat, any disclosures?
No, I do not have any positions, and I do not have any indices position either. Although what I did not discuss Bank Nifty, I'm actually negative. Maybe some of my clients might have Bank Nifty short positions at higher levels, because I do not see Bank Nifty going up much from here.
Okay. And Ashwini, for you, any disclosures?
We have some long position on financials.
All right.